Mic off. I don't understand. Okay. My microphone is enabled. Let's see. What else?
The Ravens.
The Ravens.
They've gone.
They've gone.
No.
Half of them have gone.
They've gone. Some are still there.
But where? Some are still there.
Will Ravens help him?
He's not helping.
It's a trick.
Quiet.
Out in the wild, in the cold winter woods,
where have they gone?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. But she remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become.
Ravens. They've all gone.
No. There's still three.
There's three.
Where have they gone?
Where have they gone?
She did it, but what does it mean?
Looking back, I was so naive to think she could banish it on her own. The further she saw into the darkness, the more she struggled to see anything at all. And the gloom. The smallest hints of shape, sound, or thought. grow in strength until they consumed her whole. Before she knew it, the darkness had her in its claws. There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill her. Yet, it will gnaw at her, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillion before her time comes?
Overcome Valravan's final illusion to face him in his keeping. I know you can do it, Senua. You have the sight.
We both see the darkness. We can fight it together. Speak to me, Druth. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findon. The Northmen captured Findon's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. But when he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon? Burnt away that day. But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth, the man that I am now. And though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these dark times.
Thank you.
gate is open.
It's open.
It's darkness. I know it from the wilds. It's coming back for me. Didn't end well in the wilds. It never does. You think you can overcome the darkness, make sense of it, and once relief settles in, it strikes out of nowhere, throwing you helplessly back into the maelstrom, drowning the mind in fear, deeper, deeper, dragging you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back.
Help me.
But there, in the darkness,
Senua.
And she remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me. Senua. Take my iron mirror. Look into it. For it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus, like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped within yours. Focus! Focus! Focus!
I see you! I see you now! You led me to the wilds! You trapped me there!
Where's he going?
Valravn, one of the keys to the gate to Helheim. Hold it in your mind's eye.
With every battle, the darkness grows stronger. Every victory, bringing her closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for Druth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. And she would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul.
I'm coming. I still hear you. When she was younger, she would lay in the grass and stare at the plants. And now she saw them. Elusive. Shifting faces. After a while, she could see the faces everywhere.
you see the faces too? They're there. If you look for them.
The mark of Valravn and the mark of Surt, you may cross the bridge over the River of Knives to Helheim.
Why is she waiting?
Don't open the gate!
Open the gate.
Don't. No, it's dangerous. It's dangerous. Don't open the gate. Don't.
She's done it.
There is no one here but me.
Not you.
Did you think that I would let you go? That you lost me back in the wilds? I will never let you go. You can't get rid of me. I am your shadow. And I will be watching when you draw your last dying gasp.
I'm not ready to die.
You will be when you see what they did to your dear beloved. They came through stormy black seas. They raided these shores. Do you still hear his screams? And now that you're home, he's so far away. They've taken his soul. These gods you cannot pray. They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through his darkness you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart. You fought for love unspoiled by your darkness within. You fought for your dreams. Now there's no way to win. In the head of his corpse lies the seat of his soul. So you must carry his vessel to bring him back home.
Where?
killed her. You did. No. You did. No.
They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through this darkness, you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart. The darkness touched you. Everyone could see it in the hollows of your eyes. A gaze averted from life. You ran from it but brought it nearer. Led it to him. An endless suffering worse than death. And you wanted to surrender, abandon him to find peace with the gods. No. The darkness won't allow it. So you will walk into the lair of the beast. Look it in the eye, and you will go to war. This is your mission. This is your quest. There is nothing else left.